Good morning, good evening, and good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, men and women, whatever place it is that you're joining on to the Life Signatures Radio. It's a daily show. We talk about purpose, productivity, and resilience, and we normally deploy this in the form of a series. Yesterday, we did begin talking about something new, and something in this series is about the reasons as to why people do not turn their purpose into profit. That's what we're going to be discussing in the next several episodes. I don't know how many episodes that will take, but that's the topic. There's purpose on one end, there's productivity on the other end, there's resilience on the other end, then there is profit at the end of the day. If you are doing your life and you're not getting any profit out of your purpose, there's just something that is disconnecting anywhere, somewhere. It could be ignorance, it could be you do not know, it could be you think that things related to purpose cannot be charged. There's a guy called Zig Ziglar who says that if you have found a way of helping this world, it's your moral obligation to charge for it. I'm paraphrasing him. Therefore, we're going to be talking about why people do not turn their purpose into profit in this episode. So stay tuned.
Welcome to the Life Signatures Podcast with Lawrence Namale. Lawrence is a life coach, author, and keynote speaker who loves to tackle different topics on purpose, productivity, and resilience. His mission in life is to awaken all your boundless possibilities available in you. Life Signatures Podcast is dedicated to bring to reality every single person who knows that deep down in their gut, there's got to be more to life than this. And now, here is your host, Lawrence Namale.
Problem that we face is joblessness. It's very interesting that there is no country, whether it's developed or it's developing or whatever, that this problem is not touching. It's a global situation. In fact, sometimes even in the Americas, when you're hearing people are going to the elections, one of those numbers that are being thrown around is the joblessness numbers, new jobs and so on. And I've always wondered who was the first person to ever be declared to be a jobless person. I mean, what was the circumstance? What were the circumstances around their situation for them being declared jobless? And are they the same, those circumstances, are they the same today? Did that person have purpose in their life? The person who was declared jobless, do they have purpose? Did they discover their purpose? What really was going on? If you fast forward the same question today, you can still ask, why is it that people are jobless today? What is the pervading circumstances under which these people are being declared jobless? Man, countries have policies that are geared towards solving this systemic problem. And chief among these interventions is, guess what? Education. Education systems are crafted so that people can get qualifications in order to get a job. We are told that education is the key. And one of the glaring misses of education systems, you will guess it, the world over, is the subject of personal purpose and vision. I mean, you learn all there is to learn in technical and theoretical fields, but we miss one major component, where to begin with. We miss the nucleus of our lives, which is our purpose. And so you find many talented and gifted people jobless. Why? All along, they have something that can be monetized. All along, they have their uniqueness in there. So traditionally, people get employed for the most part out of their academic qualifications. Every time you see someone who has no academic qualifications, you already brand them a failure. Anytime you see someone who's going through an academic system and they are not proceeding to the next levels, for one reason or another, you brand them a failure. I never forget when I was in primary school, we had a head teacher who had quite a number of kids. And one of those kids that the head teacher had was a very poor academician. Very, very poor. But the guy was a genius in electronics. You give him a radio, he's stripping. You give him a watch, he's stripping. This was way back in the 80s, late 80s, early 90s. I mean, the guy who had never gone into any technical school, any engineering school, any whatever radio school, but the guy would strip the radios open and he will repair any radio that is given to him. It was being considered a dwarf academically because that was the main gauge that people were using those days to determine the smartness of people. So people get employed traditionally for the most part out of the academic qualifications, and we need to change that increasingly so that people can do what is in their field of ability. For the sake of this podcast, I'll have to use the following aspects to depict purpose. And I'm going to just talk about 1, 2, 3, and maybe I'm not going to talk about all of them today, but I'm just going to talk about few things that cut across every human strata devoid of education. In other words, if there was no education, let me just rephrase that, if there was no academic qualifications, what four things will remain constant the world over? Number one, I'm going to talk about this: ideas. If you reached Steve Jobs, maybe if you read his biography, and someone is saying, here we go again with Steve Jobs. But if you read his biography, you realize that Apple was just an idea. It was an idea. It was also a passion. There were gifts and there were talents involved. But let's talk about ideas for the most part. Let's talk about ideas. An interesting thing about ideas is that they do not come fully formed. That's what Mark Zuckerberg said in his commencement speech at Stanford at some point in time, that ideas do not come fully formed. But all of us, as long as you've got a mind, as long as you have a brain, there will be an opportunity for you to have ideas. And also you'll notice that the ideas at times revolve around things that you are passionate about, things that you do not do, things that you do not care about, you seldom get ideas about them. And I'm more than 100% sure that there are millions of people who have no jobs. A great percentage of these people have ideas in their minds. You will not find a human being who lacks ideas. In fact, I do think and I do believe that every single day, I tell you, every single day we have ideas coming to us. It's like they're looking for us. They are coming in our minds, in our spirits, in our psyches, our ideas all over the place, ideas all over the place. But we don't give a second look, a second thought, a second consideration of these ideas, because we are predominantly predisposed to judge our lives on the value of the education or the academics that we have. But around the world, there is no discrimination on the terms of ideas when it comes to education. In fact, let me just say it the other way around. The whole wide world, ideas don't discriminate people who don't have an education, academic or whatever. One needs to ask why ideas are not implemented. I personally have over 10 ideas for books, just books. Online courses, seminars, and so on that are yet to be seen. They are yet to see the light of the day. And I'm not so sure the extent to which these ideas can go. You don't know. You have no idea how these ideas will go. You don't know whom they will help. You don't know the extent. You don't know the magnitude. But they are there. That's the same place where Steve Jobs and Steve Wozniak were when they started Apple. They did not know where will go. They didn't have the faintest, foggiest idea. They didn't. It is the same place where Bill Gates and Jeff Bezos and Jack Ma and Aliko Dangote, wow, when they started out, they didn't know. They didn't know. It's the same place where Elon Musk was when he started. He didn't know that at some point in time, NASA itself will be hiring rockets from him. He didn't know. You don't know. You are in the same place. I am in the same place. When we have ideas, we are in the same place. We don't know the extent of which these ideas are going to go. We have no clue. We have no faintest idea about them. But the only difference is that these people chose to lean into these ideas. They chose to go the extra mile. They chose to be crazy enough. That's why one of the most iconic advertisements was launched by Apple, which says, think different. They say that these are the bunch of crazy ones, the round holes and square pegs. They push the limits, they push the world forward, because they have chosen not to fit in but to stand out. These are guys who decide to, I'm going to go look weird, but I'm going to pursue this idea. And sometimes people laugh at you. When you start, they laugh at you because you look crazy. You're not fitting in. It's not status quo. Until it starts to make sense, then that's when people start bandwagoning on your idea. Let me say this, let us close this episode today. Ideas are equalizers. They don't discriminate. They don't discriminate the races. How many people who are black who invented things? The other day we just discovered there are very many black guys who invented crazy stuff and they have never been documented. Or celebrated. We celebrate the Edisons of this world. But the Booker T. Washingtons? Ideas don't discriminate race, color, gender. They don't discriminate religions. As long as you are a human being, you have ideas. That's the starting place. When we're talking about purpose, I mean the ideas you're going to get will revolve around your purpose. Tomorrow we're going to look at another equalizer when it comes to purpose deployment. And remember, we are talking in these episodes about why people do not monetize their purpose. But until then, tomorrow, stay tuned and bye-bye.
Thank you for listening to Life Signatures Radio. If you enjoyed today's show, subscribe to Life Signatures Radio on iTunes, Stitcher, or visit our website at lifesignatures.libsyn.com. Life Signatures Radio, fresh, clean, and inspiring.